Morning, everyone. It's Friday morning. Grab a Bible, turn with me to Philippians chapter 1, where we were thinking yesterday about this conflict that Paul is feeling in his life and his ministry. He's weary, he's worn down, his future's uncertain. He's wondering if he's coming to the end of the road, and it would just be better to go and be with Christ in eternity. But he's feeling torn because he can see the value of continuing in fruitful labour for the Philippians. And so he feels this conflict, and today we're going to see how he resolves that conflict, and we're going to see that his concern is for the Philippians more than it is for himself. So let me pray, and then we'll look at it together. Let's pray. Father God, many of us know what it's like to feel weary and worn down. We know what it's like to look at a future that feels very uncertain. And we just pray that as we come to your word this morning, we would see that that was how Paul felt. And we pray that our hearts might be warmed as we see his heart for the Philippians, his heart for others. And we pray that we might grow in that godly concern for other people as well. Help us, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we've seen already in chapter 1 Paul's concern for the advance of the gospel when he was locked up in prison. That was what he cared about above all. And now here we see his concern more personally as a pastor for the Philippians. I'm going to read from verse 21 so we get the flow of the argument, but then we'll look at it from verse 24. Follow with me. Paul writes, "For me to live is Christ and to die is gain. If I am to go on living in the body, this will mean fruitful labour for me. Yet what shall I choose? I do not know. I am torn between the two. I desire to depart and be with Christ, which is better by far. But it is more necessary for you that I remain in the body. Convinced of this, I know that I will remain, and I will continue with all of you for your progress and joy in the faith, so that through my being with you again, your boasting in Christ Jesus will abound on account of me." How does Paul resolve this conflict? Well, he says, you can see it here in verse 24, "It is more necessary for you that I remain in the body." That is, that I carry on living in this life, in my physical body. His concern is for them, for the Philippians. We've been learning in church on Sundays in the last few weeks that church, it's not about me, it's about my brothers and sisters in Christ. It's not about me, says Paul, it's about you, the Philippians. And so he's convinced of this, verse 25. So he says, I know that I will remain. I'll continue with all of you for your progress and joy in the faith. That's his priority. That's his overriding concern. And I love the way, do you see here how he denies himself for the sake of the Philippians? He submits his desire to be with Christ to the bigger concern, which is their spiritual growth. Now, it's not that he suppresses his desire to be with Christ. We should long to be with Christ in eternity. That's a good thing. That's a work of the Spirit in our hearts, if you feel that. But he's willing to submit that desire for the greater concern of the Philippians' spiritual health. It's not about me, he says, it's about you. Yesterday, I mentioned my mum. Who is now with Christ in eternity. That is for her better by far. But I can imagine when I see her again one day, I can imagine her saying to me, she died in June last year, I can imagine her saying, "Darling, if I'd known it was going to be so hard, if I'd known there was going to be another lockdown, if I'd known there'd be a second wave, I'd have stayed a bit longer to look after you all, to care for you all, to kind of, you know, to be there for you. I'm so sorry, you know, I'd have stayed longer if I'd known." Because that was my mum all over. Her concern was for others before herself. She wanted to be there to look after us. That's why we miss her so much. I can imagine that's how she would think, looking at the world we're in now. This is how Paul felt about the Philippians. He said, "It's not about me, it's about you. And I'm willing to continue with all of you." Why, verse 25? For your progress. The Christian life is one in which we're meant to make progress. We're meant to grow in godliness and maturity. And Paul wanted also to continue with them for their joy. The Christian life is one of joy. Now, how do we experience that joy? Well, with one another. That's why Paul wanted to stay with them. He wanted to help them to continue growing in joy, the joy that we find in Christ. It's a wonderful picture, isn't it, of selflessness. And I guess it raises the question for us, what could you do? What could we do for the progress and joy of our brothers and sisters here at St. James in the faith? What could you do today? What could you do over this weekend to help your brothers and sisters here in your church family to make progress with Jesus and to enjoy him more? Let's think about that as we pray. Father God, we thank you for your word to us this morning, and we pray that you might grow in us that selflessness born out of love for Christ and love for his people. That means our concern is not for ourselves, but for our brothers and sisters. That our priority would be their progress, their joy in the faith. And we ask, Father, therefore, you might help us to submit our desires, even our desire to be with Christ one day in eternity, to the bigger priority of seeing others grow in Christ. And we pray that here at St. James, we would be a community where people are boasting in Christ Jesus more and more because we are loving him and getting to know him every day. In his name we pray. Amen.
Have a really good day.